Hi, I'm AJCrunch94, and this is my review of my Model 1 PlayStation 2. Now, the Model 1 is slightly better because it has an expansion bay. I've never really seen a Model 1. Well, I've seen a Model 2, but it's not that cool. And it has, like, stand-up, so you can stand it up anywhere. See? It's big and bulky, and it can stand up to anything. Take it over. Now, don't have nothing in my expansion bay, but except a Superman sticker. Now, here's some other ports right here, and right here, 2 USB fan. It never overheats. Never, ever, 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 ever overheats. Now, I'm missing my disc thing, because I got it from my friend for fixing one of his controllers, and I said it was like for $50, so he just gave me a PlayStation 2. I was like, fuck yeah. So I just took it in. This is my PlayStation 2. It has pegs, everything, all the features. Now, here is the most kick-ass thing that you could ever find. My friend bought this at GameStop. He gave it to me. Now, this is cool. 360. GameCube and Nintendo 64, Xbox, old school, and guess what? PlayStation 3 and PlayStation 2 port. I don't know if it has PlayStation, but yeah. So here is my PlayStation 1 memory card. I just bought this today, and it's pretty cool because I can save my games on here. I couldn't save my PlayStation 1 games. Sony should add that feature in the PlayStation 2 memory card. Be able to save PlayStation 1 games, that will be spectacular. But I guess Sony was like, oh, hey, guys, they already have PlayStation 1. Why will we update the PlayStation 2 memory card? Shit, yeah, Steve, you're like the smartest guy in the company. I know. Here's my PlayStation 2 memory card. It has Sean Palmer. Well, I'm not going to tell my games. But yeah, it's 8 megabyte. Same RAM. Just color it a little silver. Still has this little silvery thing. Both of them have their little silvery things. Now, on to the PlayStation 2 controller. All the features still work. See? So, analog stick, except this analog stick is stuck right here. Right here. So, it kind of stands in one place for a little bit. Yeah. Kind of does that shit. So, that's what pissed me off. Like, what we do? What we plan to fix that shit. I bought this controller like a day ago from Walmart. $10.82. That was my. This is a good controller. It's very cheap, very sturdy. Okay, it has all the same things. The handle is a little uncomfortable because I'm used to the regular one. That's what really turns me off about it. Now, the one thing I like about the Model 1 is because it doesn't have that big ass power brick. I mean, you know it's weird? Sony used the same power brick that you power up a laptop with, which is kind of stupid. I'm like, what the fuck? Why would you do that? Sony, slap yourself. Alrighty. This is where you stick the PlayStation thingy in. This is the way you put the PlayStation in. And this way you plug it up to the wall. No brick at all. Nothing. And a couple of more days, I'll do my review of all my PlayStation games. I'll give my PlayStation Model 1 a 10 out of 10 because it has an expansion bay. I don't know if Model 1 ever had expansion bay. I never picked the Model 1 up. Never seen a Model I see them on the one, but I never ask my friend if it has expansion bay. But yeah. One weird thing is, it says it can read anything with a USB, but it cannot read computer controllers. Because before I bought this bad boy right here, I tried to plug in my computer controller. I just played emulator games, and yeah, it wouldn't work. So I was like, ooh, shit, at least I tried. But yeah, 10 out of 10. If you have a Model 2 already, seriously, just stay with the Model 1. It's like badass. And plus, nobody with grubby hands can touch your lens because it's inside. It's inside. It's inside. Yeah. See you later, folks.